Good morning and welcome to today's Products in Focus. So I actually have a fair amount to talk about. Obviously, we've seen a big rebound in the Japanese markets after they slid into recession. But now, you know, global stock markets all jumped up higher. Japanese market actually erased all the losses that it had yesterday as snap elections and potential delay in additional consumption tax out there has really kind of changed the landscape as ever. So really bad news coming out. Japan recession and most global markets are up higher. So as you can see by the candle we had yesterday, this is very, very bullish in the short term, considering we were quite negative first thing in the morning last time we looked at this. To finish in positive territory is a testament to the strength of the US market. We are looking a little bit soft this morning, but very strong candles. These long legs right here indicate of the strength. Up here, you look there on Thursday and we had the opposite way, but we've got to always look to the future. So this certainly doesn't look that weak in the short term, but we've got to push above 17.665 to gain some extra momentum. So that would be good in the short term. We do have a fair amount of UK data due later on today. So looking at the UK 100, punching through 6666, eyeing up 67.74, almost getting a golden cross in the moving averages. We are moving into overbought territory on the RSI and the slow stochastic, but there still is a little bit of extra room for maneuver. Most traders looking at cable, that's probably the best product to look at if you want to take advantage of the CPI and PPI. We'll come back to that in a second though, okay? So Japan 225, moving back up to the upside. It's got a breakthrough 17.435. It's not done it yet. It's not completely erased all the losses yesterday, but quite close to it. We're just waiting for a little bit more insight as to what Shinzo Abe's going to be doing next. Are they going to have the snap elections and when? And how much of a majority are they going to get to push through more monetary reform out there? Everything that is a little bit more hearsay. We were expecting that the consumption tax increase is going to be delayed. When Japan's slumping into recession, it's kind of hard to justify that right now. So we'll have to see to wait what happens. Dollar yen soldiering on. You know our longer-term potential resistance is 124.42. You know Japan, Bank of Japan gets interventionist the closer we get to 120. There's still a little bit of room for maneuver there on dollar-yen. Things looking quite good. Obviously, dollar looking very strong. The yen, if we're thinking about more stimulus to support the Japanese economy, that's not going to be so good. So the fundamentals are still behind dollar-yen pushing up higher. And obviously, if Japanese equities become quite bullish again, you're looking at people selling the yen and buying the dollar to hedge their equity positions as well. So there could still be a little bit of a perfect alignment there for dollar-yen for some traders to take advantage of. But we're not that far away from 120 right now, and that's when things, you know, there can be quite a harsh turnaround if there is intervention by the Bank of Japan. 100 pips, 150 pips in the wrong direction, you don't want to be on that side. So West Texas crude, pressurized as ever, global slowdown fears still impacting this. Longer term potential support remains at 70.41. Venezuela and Russia looking at defense measures to support crude oil prices in the short term. They're simply just not big enough, I don't think, to have a meaningful impact. There certainly seems to be a lot of political forces at work to try and keep crude oil West Texas low to help support the global economy, but also to hurt some of these countries that are very dependent on crude oil and energy and have not invested in other parts of their infrastructure. So Russia, very, very vulnerable to lower crude oil prices, and they're trying to do everything that they can to defend those prices, but they're just simply not big enough. So looking at gold had a bit of a shot in the arm. Even with that stronger dollar strength kind of creeping in there, and you know, I guess interest rates maybe seem like a bit of a distant memory right now, but gold certainly moving in the right direction. 1180 working as a kind of springboard. We're trading above that 21 period SMA. I need to actually redraw some of the technical some of the support resistance levels on here, but 1218 looking to be the next potential support on gold if we still get that momentum pushing us further forward. So euro dollar is an interesting one. So volatile session as ever. Wrong side of 1.2498. More talk of stimulus. Eurozone economy is really struggling right now. But we've had a bit of a resurge this morning, trying to hit that level again. It looks to be the pivot on euro dollar, 1.2498. The longer term potential support still remains 1.2047. I can't really see a large number of fundamentals that are supporting euro dollar to punch up that level higher and say re-challenge, you know, 127, 128. But we are bouncing around 124, or let's say 125 really. I've got 124.98, but it's really 125. This seems to be the level depending on what decision you guys at home decide to make, this is the level that's going to be the next phase for your dollar. You're going to get a bounce up higher and start to look at these areas right here, but I just don't see it fundamentally, or we start to have that slow creep further forward. But all depends on the macroeconomics. Eurozone still looking a little bit weak, and I guess the US markets could do with being a little bit more directional. There has been a couple of mixed bits of data coming out there, but certainly the US economy looking a little bit stronger than Eurozone in the short term. So looking at cable, as I mentioned before, this is probably the one to look at if you want to take advantage of that macroeconomic picture. Sterling tending to get bashed about a fair bit right now, especially by any US dollar strength. 1.5742 is the potential resistance. That was reconfirmed yesterday. We had a retracement and moved right back down to the downside yesterday. We're looking at 1.5424 as the next potential support level. A little bit cleaner than some of the other charts there, a little bit more directional, and we do have some fundamentals to help edge that down further if these come in a little bit worse than expected. ZEW, the business report, also due at 10 a.m. UK time, will be helpful for traders looking at euro dollar, and we do have US PPI data as well. So you've got a fair amount of macroeconomic data that could impact cable today if that's your forte. Not a lot happening tomorrow. I guess if you're a crude oil trader, you do have crude oil stocks net change, which as ever could be quite volatile for West Texas crude. We fast forward on to Thursday, you've got some Chinese data, PMI, UK retail sales, US CPI and employment jobless claims figures. Matter of fact, we've got a huge amount of data coming out on Thursday, so that should be quite an exciting session as well. Keep your eye on the chart forum as ever. Lots of trades set up from our global analyst team. Some really good bits of analysis going up there right now. Make insights part of your layout. This is obviously also from our global analyst team to help support you in your trading decisions. And join me again tomorrow to find out what happened next.